morning, everybody. My name is Emanuele Sgamistella from the University of Calabria. And today I want to talk to you about the last investigation we are doing recently in order to evaluate on chain memory alloy the effect of the fractured properties of nickel titanium based chain memory alloys of the higher order terms in the Williams expansion, the investigation region near the crack tip, and the temperature. Even in this case, as well as the last presentation did yesterday, the technique we are going to use is a digital image correlation. So, the reason why we decided to start this kind of investigation is that actually, as you know, it's really hard to investigate the fracture properties of shape memory alloys due to the phase transformation near the crack tip. So there are several techniques able to do something like that, like finite element method, modeling, and X-ray diffraction. But actually, about the effective fracture properties of nickel titanium shape memory alloys, there are still many lacks in literature, and there are several results quite different among them. So another aspect we are going to do is to validate an analytical model we developed in our department, where in order to describe the effective stress evolution near the crack tip, you have to use two important parameters I will discuss later. And with this technique, the digital image correlation, we try to actually investigate and validate the value we have to use in order to describe this stress evolution here. So the approach is mainly experimentally, and we use the digital image correlation in order to investigate piezoelastic material for different operating temperatures in the range between 25 Celsius degrees and 65 Celsius degrees. So we investigated different investigation region near the crack tip and different fitting procedures, strategies I will talk about later. After that, we investigate this kind of shape of the sample. We evaluated the important parameters I discussed later in the modeling, and we validated the model. We try to validate the model. Actually, this is a first approach, so our preliminary results, and we are going to work about. So here we have the outline. So I don't want to spend more time to talk about nickel titanium memory alloys. So everyone knows the properties. I will show you the material and the methods adopted, results and the conclusion and future perspective. So, you know, nickel titanium shell memory alloys is very important for their capability to get solid phase transformation between austenite and martensite. And for this reason, you have two important effects, the piezoelastic one and the shape memory one. And here we have many application field for this kind of alloy. So here, we have the typical shape memory effect. So if you heat up, if you have a transformation from martensite to austenite, if you cool down, you have phase transformation from austenite to martensite. And here the phase transformation is due to the application of an external load. So, and you can have a big recovery in terms of deformation around 8 or 10%. This is actually the material that we use. And as you can see from the stress and response, is a piezoelastic one. And from the thermogram, you can see that in the range we are working 25, 65 Celsius degrees, the material is still piezoelastic. And this is the sample. It's a single edge crack sample. We generated the notch with an NDR machine with a 0.1 millimeter of diameter. And after that, we started with fatigue tests in order to create the crack till a length around 3.5 millimeter. Okay, digital image correlation is the technique we use in our investigation. I discussed about yesterday about this technique. So with this kind of technique, you can actually evaluate the displacement field around a crack tip or actually in a correlation region. So I don't want to spend more words about that, and this is the typical experimental setup you need to perform experiment with this kind of technique. So you need a sample, a white light source, lens camera, and a computer to connect and manage everything. And this is actually what we did. So our investigation region is very close to the crack tip, and With this technique, we are able to investigate on the displacement field that we are going to record around the crack tip. So we performed several tests at different operating temperatures in this range, and the maximum load is around 300 Newton, and we fixed the temperature using a Peltier cell, and we check it, control it, using a thermocouple. This is the typical load unloading test we performed, and during the test, in order to measure the displacement field, you have to take pictures. So the first one is the reference one at zero load, and after that, it depends on how many pictures you want, of course. You can take several pictures during the load, during the unload. And this is a typical picture you can get from the maximum load. And here, actually, there is the crack completely open for the 300 Newton of load. The other approach we use in our investigation is the analytical model I discussed developed in our department, and with this model we are able to identify actually the evolution of the stress around the crack tip using an approach like Irwin, you know, the Irwin approach. And here you can see you have the elastic response of the austenitic phase, here you have the phase transformation, and here you have the elastic response of the martensitic phase. With this model, following this flow chart, you can calculate actually this stress evolution that is governed by the K1 of the austenite parameter. And here, the stress evolution is governed by the K1 of the martensitic phase. So, with our approach, with a digital image correlation, our idea is to try to calculate experimentally these values that actually are important parameter in order to describe this kind of evolution. If you perform an experimental test using the digital image correlation, you are able to get this kind of results in terms of displacement field, vertical displacement field. And of course, to get this very smooth data, you need to optimize many parameters like the speckle pattern, image resolution, fitting region, and several parameters of the code you are going to use. And starting from the displacement field, what we did in order to calculate the K1 at the crack tip is actually a fitting procedure. So you will start from the experimental results, the blue one, and you compare these results with the analytically predicted by the Williams expansion. If you fit these results, we are able to evaluate the most important parameter of the fracture parameter, I mean, the stress intensity factor. In this case, we are able to give an input more parameter than one. I mean, you can improve the approximation that actually the linear elastic fracture mechanic gives. We actually introduce only the T-stress, the second term. And here you have the rigid rotation and the rigid translation that actually we calculated in order to evaluate the efficiency of the procedure. Because actually when you perform an experimental test, the typical results is this one, with rigid rotation and rigid displacement. So as you can see, the fitting procedure works very well. I mean, you are able to get a good comparison between experimental and analytical results. And results with the fitting is very well suitable in evaluating the effective fracture properties of the alloy. I'm telling you effective because actually you are calculating the stress intensity factor starting from the real displacement field that the material is going to experience. So, in order to calculate the K1 far away from the crack tip and the K1 close to the crack tip, so we investigated two different regions. Our bigger one, where we use the Williams expansion, giving input even the second term, the T-stress. In the other case, because we are very inside because we are very close to the crack tip, so close to the process zone, we use only the first parameter. So this is what we actually did. This is the smaller zone, this is the bigger zone, and here you can see the difference in terms of results. So if you are very close to the crack tip, of course, the introduction of the T-stress, or if you want to delete it, of course, the results is not very different. But if the zone is very big, in this case you can see that if you will not introduce the T-stress terms, of course, far away from the process zone. The results tend to, they don't give you a convergency, of course. And here, these are the K1 we calculated from the proceeding, from the fitting procedure, considering the T-stress and without considering the T-stress. Of course, here you have convergency, here not. And we try to compare the ratio we got here with the analytically predicted. And as you can see here, actually, there is still a mismatch, so we are going to work about that. These are only preliminary results. And here, finally, we have the evolution of the K1 as a function of the temperature calculated for the maximum applied load. And as you can see, increasing the temperature, you have actually a decreasing of the stress intensity factor. It's a toughening effect. And another aspect is actually when you increase the temperature, the gradient is lower than the lower temperature. This is a very important result because actually we performed experimental tests to calculate the toughness of the material at different operating temperature. This is the experimental results. And for the linear elastic fracture mechanic, when you increase the temperature, of course, you have an increasing of the maximum applied load and the toughness tends to increase. But if you try to calculate this value with an analytical model, actually, you don't have effect from the temperature. And this is actually is not the real toughness of the material, because actually, it should be something like that, because the constant value here is governed by the toughening effect of the stress intensity factor as a consequence of the Clausius-Clapeyron law, an increasing of the stress transformation. So to conclude, we evaluated the effect of higher order terms in the Williams series, the effect of the temperature and fracture properties of nickel alloy, and the experimental results reveal that actually nickel titanium alloy showed an unusual fracture behavior negative as a consequence of the phase transformation. The DAC technique is suitable in investigating the fracture properties of the alloy starting from the displacement field, and the DAC on estimating the effective fracture properties of the alloy. Future work, we are going to perform high resolution investigation in order even to evaluate the toughness of the material and investigate the effective elastic properties to consider at the crack tip. That actually is one of the most important issues of this kind of alloy. Thank you.